Welcome to episode 7 of the Satoria Nicole Show. This is a super dope episode done with the youth out here in Hampton Roads. They're going to talk to us about what they want to see change in the community. So stay tuned. Don't go nowhere. You're tuned in to the Satoria Nicole Show.
If you have a dream, you just go for it. No pause, just do it, man, go for it. If they say you can't, you go harder for it. Don't stop, just do it, just go for it. If you have a dream, you just go for it. No pause, just do it, man, go for it. If they say you can't, you go harder for it. Don't stop, just do it, just go for it. Just go for it, 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 just go for it.
What's up, world? It's your girl, Satoria Nicole. You are tuned in to the Satoria Nicole Talk Show, Sky4 TV. We got Young Lady the Great in the building. Y'all give it up for Young Lady the Great. Yeah, she is here from Patterson, New Jersey, 11 years old. 11. You get that a lot? Do people talk about your age a lot?
Yeah, some people think I'm like 7 years old.
That means when you get older, you're going to still look young.
That's a good thing.
Yeah, that's a great thing. So you're 11 years old, you own Teeny Boppers Entertainment, correct?
Yes.
So how old were you when you started your own record label?
I was 7 years old, and that's when I actually started rapping. And so we decided that we wanted our own record label only for kids.
Okay, so it's only kids under your record label.
Yeah, we only sign kids from 5 to 16 years old.
Okay, so how many kids do you have signed right now?
We have me, then we have Young A, we have my little brother, we have my two little sisters. So it's a couple of little kids that we got right now. We're trying to actually get more.
Okay, so you out here looking for talent too. Oh, you gonna see some talent in here today. Maybe you might sign somebody. So, you know, what made you say at 7 years old, I want to be a rapper?
My dad actually kind of inspired me because he was a rapper when he was back then. So he kind of like inspired me, and we just started doing it, and we just kept on.
That's awesome. So at 7 years old, what were you rapping about?
Actually, it was just like me having fun and me just being a little kid. That's really it. It wasn't really nothing like what I do now about like stop the violence and stuff like that.
So yeah, I say now that you're 11 years old, what are you rapping about? You said stop the violence.
Yeah, stop the violence. More so what's going on in Patterson, because Patterson is like crazy right now.
I heard they call it the zoo out there.
Yeah, it is the zoo out there. So we just really rap about that, but we still like rap around me like me having fun and me being a kid.
Y'all created a new genre of music.
Yes, our genre of music is called Inspir Soul.
And what? Tell me what Inspir Soul is.
Inspir Soul is like, it's inspiring, but it's like a hip-hop version. Like, you know how they have like gospel rap, but like everyone thinks that they don't want to listen to gospel rap. But it's Inspir Soul is gospel rap, but mixed with new rap, mixed with like old, like it's mixed with like all everything. And it's not just gospel, is not just talking about one specific thing.
Okay, so outside of your dad, who are some other artists that inspire you and have an impact on your music?
My Uncle Quest, he really inspires me too. And I like most of the old school rappers, like Slick Rick and Big Daddy Kane and all of them.
What you know about Slick Rick and Big Daddy Kane and them?
My father told me. He teaches me all about the old school rappers. I'm not really into the new school rap right now.
So what make you not into the new school rap?
Too much violence in it. Always talking about like selling drugs and all that stuff. I'm not like, I just push away from that. I don't even want to listen to that.
So you don't let it brainwash you. You don't let it, you know, take over your mind. Because, like, I went, you know, I go different places and I hear kids that want to hear that type of music. And I'm like, why would you even want to listen to that? Because I know when I was younger, I was still playing with Barbies and coloring and all that stuff. And, you know, all the way through high school. So, you know, I was just, I don't know, I guess weird is what they say, uncool. But now I'm on TV. You know what I'm saying? And so you're 11 and you have your own record label. What is some advice that you can give to kids?
Just keep following your dreams and don't let nobody tell you you can't do nothing. As long as you put your mind to it, you can do everything.
I know that's right. Let's real quick, let's talk about this. This is the introduction, volume 13, the final chapter, by Young Lady the Great. So what is this about?
That's what we do is with that. I have 13 volumes of that. What we do is we take, this is, that's before the mixtape. So we have like 1 through 13 and it's all like mixtape stuff, like, and that one is actually new stuff and nothing on that is on the other ones. This is the last one. After this comes the mixtape.
Okay, so what can we expect from Young Lady the Great in 2016?
Lots of more shows, more songs, of course, more everything. Just looking forward to doing a lot more stuff.
And tell me, how was opening up for Fetty Wap?
It was cool. It was nice. I had a lot of fun. That was actually that was the biggest performance I ever did.
How many people were there?
About 1,200 people.
That's what's up. That's what's up. So were you nervous?
That's the first show I could say I was a little nervous.
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
Well, don't be nervous today when you perform. I just want to really thank you for coming out here way from Paterson, New Jersey. Like, that really means a lot to me as you came on. That's a little long drive.
Yeah, it is a long drive.
Was it boring?
Well, yeah, kind of.
Yeah, kind of. That's what's up. Well, tell everybody where they can find you on social media, your website.
You guys can find me on Instagram, at The Real Young Lady the Great. You guys can find me on Facebook, Jayana Wilson. And you guys can find me on YouTube, Real Star Hip Hop. I got my single on iTunes, Spotify. It's called Teach You. So if you guys want to go and check that out.
Yes, and shout out to the 2 million views you got on World Star.
Yeah.
And she didn't pay to get her video put on World Star. World Star put her on World Star. She got 2 million views. So y'all give it up for that. That was awesome. So again, thank you for coming.
No problem. Thank you for having me.
No problem at all.
Every girl around the world. Every
Can you tell me how do you feel that affects children your age?
Mad.
But like, do you feel like it affects you for like how you act or like what you're gonna be like when you grow up?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So that's why you need to stop. So why did you start Righteous Kids?
Because I wanted to say Black Lives Matter, because black people keep on getting shot by cops. So I wanted to say Black Lives Matter, and that nothing, mostly not least, but I wanted to make money, because I didn't want my mom to get the money on food. For us, so I can just get the money for myself, and then I can buy myself some food.
I know that's right. You're gonna be a young boss. So tell everybody how they can follow you and find you and everything that's going on with Righteous Kids.
So you can follow me on Instagram, just write Righteous Kids, and you can follow me on Facebook, Righteous Kids also. And I think I have my business cards in the car. So if you want to have some business cards, it's that white car over there. So. I can give you my business card and Gmail, Righteous Kids, and the rest of them, Righteous Kids. So follow me if you want to see what's going on.
Okay, well, thank you, Junior, for coming on the Satoria Nicole Show.
You're welcome.
And you don't like bullying.
No.
And you look really cool.
Thanks.
So you look like you have a lot of friends at school.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. Are you quiet at school?
No.
No? Are you the class clown at school? Do you get in trouble?
No.
No? That's good. That's good. So what made you want to do a Stop the Bullying campaign?
Because I'm always, like, when I was in my third grade, I always get bullied by my height because I was, like, that big. Third grade, it was ridiculous.
Oh, you sound like my son. He's 8 right now. He's like, I'm not sure. He get really mad. So that's what it was. That's what made you do it. You been tall now. You had a growth spurt. So now what you do when you see the people that used to bully you when you was little?
I just laugh.
You just laugh. That's what's up. And then you tell other people to stop bullying.
Yeah.
That's dope. That's dope. Well, you gonna perform for us, right?
Yeah.
Y'all ready to see Young Jay perform?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm about to get out of his way. Y'all give it up for Young Jay.
A jar, no one could open the lid, so therefore he believed everyone was after the kid. The kid. The kid is still here, bullying is still going on. So listen clear when your voice start ripping the song. The road to a better future just got a little steeper, but I'm killing all wrong like the kid is the grim reaper. None changed, empty old age, his voice got deeper. Abused the father and his mother, man, she was a drinker. For the fourth time, he tried to end his life that day, but he prayed hard, and yes, he decided to stay. Yo, how he still here? That's the kid. Yo, I swear that he was dead. That's the kid. Yo, I heard they tried to jump him. That's the kid. Man, I heard that dude is crazy. That's the kid. High school coming up, now he gotta make decisions. Still picked on, yeah, but there's a thing called snitches. They make you think that if you tell it, then you must be tripping. So he stood tall, all his slander, no missing. He came home, put on his face, and he twitched until he spoke up and told anyone who would listen. No more stress, his mom's thinking, got daddy living. She sobered up, away from the bottom, no sipping. His dad gone, she told old dude, get the stepping. He can't be trusted, that's what I mean.
Do you love the Satoria Nicole Talk Show? Well, become a sponsor today. Find out how you can become a sponsor. Just email SatoriaNicoleMarketing@gmail.com.
Let's go like ooh, ooh, ah, ah, hey, hey, turn up. Ooh, ooh, ha, ha, hey, hey, turn up. Ooh, ooh, ah, ah, hey, hey, turn up. Ooh, ooh, ah, ah, hey, hey, turn up. Ooh, ooh, ah, ah, hey, hey, turn up. Like me, can't hit the corner like me, hey, can't drop like me, can't hit the folks like me.
can't do like me.
Welcome back to the Satoria Nicole Show. I'm sitting here with Kehlani Promise. What's up, Kehlani?
Nine.
What? That's what's up. Why they call you Kehlani Promise?
Because it's my first and my middle name, and that's going to be my rap name.
I go by my first and my middle name, too. We cool. That's what's up. So Kehlani Promise is going to be a rapper. I mean, her dad's already famous, Joe Flacco. You know what I'm saying? Dirty Money in the building. You mean Dirty Money Jr.?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's what's up. So who inspired you to rap?
My dad, Chef Flacco, and Nicki Minaj.
And Nicki Minaj, you make the faces Nicki Minaj made?
Not that much.
Not that much. Can I see some of them? Like, you got some bars, needs to be like a 16 for me real quick. Come on, let me get it.
I can't rap yet.
Yeah, oh, you want to rap?
Yeah.
Or you gonna rap? That's yep. What's up. So, like, what do you like to do? What else do you like to do?
I like to dance, and I like to read.
That's what's up. Kehlani like to dance, she like to read. Those are some good things, because when you rap, you got to know how to read, because you got to know how to write. And then you got to know how to dance. If you a dancing rapper, you winning, because Nicki Minaj, she can't dance all that good, but, you know, she's still bomb.
Yep.
Like, yep. Yeah.
We here with Tyjira from Lady of J's dance team. I want to know what you want to see change in the community.
No more violence. No more killing. I hate abortion. Never. I want to see less drugs, so nobody, overdoses.
Any advice you could give to any parents?
No more smoking. I hate smoking.
You hate smoking?
No. Parents, stop smoking.
Never slipping, never slumber. That's what I need. Staying with a wanna.
You want to hear a lady on a nudgy nudge kiss.
All right, I'm here with Shadiamond and the Lady of Jay's dancing. Tell me what you want to see change in the community, Shadiamond.
No more drugs.
No more drugs and no more guns. That's all. Anything you want to see parents change? It don't got to be your parents. It can be any parents. Nothing? Okay, well, no more guns and no more drugs. Y'all heard him. Shadiamond.
Are you in the Hampton Roads area? To sell or advertise your art, contact Satoria Nicole Marketing at gmail.com. Again, that's Satoria Nicole Marketing at gmail.com.
Thank you for tuning in to episode 7 of the Satoria Nicole Show. Super dope with our youth of the 757. We're going to do this about once a month, so make sure you stay tuned. If you want your kids to be involved, go to SatoriaNicole.com. Find out when we're going to have our next youth event. Make sure you come back next week, same time, same place, the Satoria Nicole Show.
If you have a dream, you just go for it. No pause, just do it, man, go for it. If they say you can't, you go harder for it. Don't stop, just do it, just go for it. If you have a dream, you just go for it. No pause, just do it, man, go for it. If they say you can't, you go harder for it. Don't stop, just do it, just go for it. Just go for 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 it.